functionality of the network layer is addressing. And as I was talking to you, you know, there are two addressing mechanism possible. One is the IPv4, other one is the IPv6. We are discussing IPv4 right now. The reason is we are in the migration phase. Still, we have not migrated completely to the IPv6. But in the future, if you become professor, probably you don't have an opportunity to discuss anything related to IPv4. It might become an history, right? So let me talk about now first an IPv4 addressing, and there are some very basic concepts, very important to understand. An IPv4 address is a 32-bit address. Please remember that uniquely and universally defines the connection of a device. What I mean by device is a computer or a laptop or your smartphone or a router, or even it could be a printer also. Two devices on the internet can never have the same address at the same time. Please understand. If I want to put my device on the internet, it has to have a unique IP address. No compromise on that. No compromise. If today you can ask me questions, sir, I became a GD guy and I want to have two IP addresses for the devices and still I want to have on internet, what will happen? What will happen is one of the device, the second get connected, it has an issue. First wala get connected. That's it. If a device operating at the network layer has M connections to the internet, it needs to have M addresses. If device operating at the network layer, I'm not talking about processes. Please don't confuse yourself. I'm not talking about the processes. You can have N number of processes, N number of N instances of the browser open. I'm saying that if a device operating at network layer has M connections to the internet, it needs to have M addresses. You can ask me a question, what do you mean by that? Let me explain you. For example, as I was telling you since long, your router is connected to multiple networks. For example, my router is connected to 10 networks. If my router is connected to 10 networks, it has that many addresses. Right? That's an important concept. Next one. You may get some numerical out of this. An address space is the total number of addresses used by the protocol, right? Space concept we will also discuss when we talk about memory system. Now look at this. If a protocol uses n bits to define an address, the address space is 2^n because each bit can have two different values, 0 or 1, and n bits can have 2^n values. So for example, my IPv4 address length is 32-bit. My IPv4 address space is 32-bit. Length is 32-bit. So what could be the address space? How many addresses are possible? The number of addresses possible are 2^32. That means I can have the address start, if I'm starting from 0, it could be 2^32 - 1. And what is that 2^32 is the value in the decimal? This is the number. Hello, this is the number. But still understand, this number is very less when it comes to the each devices in the world. And when we are moving for IoT, and that is one of the reason why we are migrating from IPv4 to IPv6, because your IPv6 length is 128 bits rather than 32 bits. And so obviously your address space is going to be 2^2. Yes, your address space is going to be 2^128. Right? So I hope you are getting what I'm trying to say. Great. So let me take you further. Now, how to represent an IP address? So generally, there are two formats which are very well known to represent your IP addresses. And the everyone loves the format is the dotted decimal notation. It is the dotted decimal notation. But still, you can represent the IP address in the binary to understand some concept, to understand some fundamental. So, maybe you need this lecture and next lecture, we'll play around binary. And then once you understand, we will say tata bye-bye to the binary notation and we will start playing with the dotted decimal notation, right? So, as I am saying, your IP address can be represented in two different ways. One is the binary, another one is the decimal. What is the total length? 32 bits. So, you can see that 32 bits. And 32 bits are separated in the four sections. Each section is of 8 bits. So this is the section number one, section number two, section number three, section number four. So these four sections are separated by dot in the decimal dotted notation, and that's the reason why it is called dotted decimal notation. So you have how many dots? One, two, and three dots to separate the four part. This binary, for example, I have to look at this 8 bits. Please look at here carefully. Let me use this annotation. Look at this carefully. What is the base value of the lowest this low significant bit? Lowest significant bit. It's 2 raised to 0. What is 2 raised to 0? What is 2 raised to 0? It is 1. So 1 into 1. What is 1 into 1? 1. Ale bhai ya 2 raised to 0 muku and multiply by 1 karu, 2 raised to 0 multiply by 1. So that comes to 1. What is the weightage of this second bit? 2 raised to 1. 2 raised to 1 is 2. 2 into 0 is 0. So what comes here is 0. So what I am getting is plus, you have to put in between plus and you have to put 0. Then third bit. What is third bit? 1. And what is the weightage? See, here weightage was 2 raised to 0. Here the weightage is 2 raised to 1. Here the weightage is 2 raised to 2. What is 2 raised to 2? 4. 4 into 1, how much? 4 into 1, how much? I know you cannot speak. 4 into 1, how much? 4. Right? But God is listening to you always. So that is 4. I hope you are getting, right? Then, what is the weightage? 2 raised to 3. 2 raised to 3 is 8. 8 into 0. 0. So that, then there is a plus. I hope you are getting plus. Yes. Plus 0. Uske baad, 2 raised to 4. 2 raised to 4 is 16. 16 into 1. 16. So plus 16. Likewise. Plus 16. Plus kya aega? Plus 16. Plus kya aega? Main beech mein abhi plus nahi kar raha hun. 32. Uske baad beech mein kya aega? Plus 64. Uske baad last digit 2 raised to 7. 2 raised to 7 here. See, 2 raised to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 2 raised to 7. 2 raised to 7 is 128. 128 is 0. Yani ki plus kya ho gaya? 0 ho gaya. Dosto, abhi sab ka sum karna hai. 64 plus 32. How much? Yes, 96 plus 16. Yes, 112 plus 4. Yes, 116 plus 1, 117, and that's how you are getting 117. Hello, this is how we have written this for 117, right? This is how we have written 117 here in decimal dotted. And if you try to convert in the similar way, you will find out 149. You try to convert this thing. See how, let me do it. 1, 4, 8 and 16. So 16 plus 8, 24. 24 plus 4, 28. 28 plus 1, 29. And that's how you are getting 29. Right? And here, it is 2 actually. So you can see 117.149.29.2. So this is how you represent the IP address in the decimal dotted notation. Same, another example. I have this this IP address in the binary notation. This is 128. See, all bits are 0. Only the most significant is 1. So 128. This is nothing but 11. You can see 1, 2, 4 and 8. 4 pe 0 hai. So 8 plus 2 plus 1. That's nothing but 11. This is 3. And this is 1, 2, 4, 8 and 16. If you do sum, it comes to 31. So that's how. If IP address is given into decimal, you can make it in binary. If it is given into binary, you can make it in this. So you have to represent this binary notation into IPv4. Can you do it? Can you do it? Right. So first, I'm helping you. Here, this is 1. 1 plus 128. So this become 129. This become 129 dot. 1, 2, 8, 11. So 129.11 plus, again it's 11. And this is, so this is only the 0, which went 1, 2, 4, 8, 16. So out of 255, if you subtract 16, 255 minus 16, 255 minus 16, yes, 239. Yes, so the first answer is 129.11.11.239. I hope you are able to do it, right? If not, please put your head, take a pen and note and do it. Code is watching you. Great. Right? So this is the solution. Same thing for the second. Right? You can convert it into 193. Right? This is nothing but 131. This is 27. And this is all set to 1. Very easy. When all set to 1, it's 255. When all set to 1, it's 255. See, I made a trick here. When only this bit was 0, I know that if all set to 1 is 255 and the weightage of this bit is, let's say, 16. So what I did was 255 minus 16, and that's how you got 239. You can make it fast. Right? So you understand how to represent an IP address between the two notations, the binary and the decimal dotted notation. So if I will give you ulta, you can always do that conversion, right? Let's try. Let's say ulta is given to you, giving you 2 minutes. 60, 59. Right? If you got this answer, you can verify. This is the correct answer for both the things, right? See, just to, if you have any doubt, I can explain you, friends. 82. See, when you want to write an 82, let me explain you how you do, actually. When I want to write an 82, actually, I have an 8 step. I have 8 boxes to fill for 82, right? Mere paas 8 drawer hai. Do, three, four, five, six, seven, aur 8 boxes hai. Isme mujhe 82 likhna hai. अच्छा, ये जो मोस्ट सिग्निफिकेंट बीट है उसको मैं 1 करूंगा तो 128 हो जाएगा, तो उसको मुझे 1 नहीं करना है. तो व्हाट आई विल डू, आई विल मेक इट 0, 128 वाला. उसके बाद 64 है, 64 को 1 करना पड़ेगा बिकॉज मुझे 182 तक पहुंचना है, राइट? सो आई हैव टू मेक इट 1. उसके बाद 32 है. इफ 64 प्लस 32 बिकम 96, और 96 82 से बढ़ जाएगा, तो इसको मैं 0 कर दूंगा. उसके बाद मेरा 16 है. So 64 plus 16, 80. So ये 1 करना है मुझे. I have to make it 1, 80. उसके बाद 8 है, ये करूंगा तो 88 हो जाएगा, 0. उसके बाद 4 है, 84 हो जाएगा, 0. ये 2 है, yes, 82. और 82 हो गया तो अभी 1 की जरूरत नहीं, तो I will make it 0. And that's how you have to do it. Right? That's how you got it. Hello. Right? For everything that you have to do like this. Right? I hope it is clear now. Okay, great. So let me move further. Next question. Find any error if any in the following IPv4 address. You have again 1 minute. Any error in the first IP address? Yes, there is an error. What is an error? What is an error? Yes, yes, 045, leading 0 is not required. Excellent. Second IP address. Second IP address. Good. Second IP address. Yes, 5 byte ho gaye hai. Right? 5 bytes ho gaye. Ye 4 bytes se zyada nahi ho sakta hai. Right? 32 bits se zyada nahi ho sakta hai. Ye to kitna ho gaya? 32 plus 8, 40 bytes ho gaya. Ye nahi chalega. Right? This is wrong. Okay, then C. Yes, 301. Maximum value possible is 255. Very good. Maximum value possible is 255. 255 is zyada hai, so error hai. Acha, D mein kya error hai? Mix nahi ho sakta. You can't have a cocktail. Either you go with a binary or you go with a decimal. Right? Look at the solution. You are absolutely right. Very enthusiastic audience I have. I'm so lucky and blessed. Correct. Right? No, yes, yes, you are right. Everybody is right. Perfect. So let me take you further now. Excellent. So I think I'm able to convince you. Now very important concept. Look at this slide. Next 5 minutes, no question answer, and you have to listen to me very carefully. I'm not looking at Q&A, but if you have any concern, you raise the hand, I will get a brief voice, right? So that's how the protocol between me and you. There are two addressing architecture trends. I think this has been already told you in the laboratories, but still, just to make it complete, there are two addressing architecture. One is called classful addressing architecture, another one is the classless. देखिए एक classful है तो दूसरे को classless होना ही पड़ेगा, right? So life is very simple. Don't take it so difficult. One is classful, another is classless. I will tell you, at present, nobody is using classful addressing architecture. This is out of date. This is outdated. Then you can ask me question, why you are teaching something which is outdated, right? The question is very much valid, right? The answer to the question is, in order to appreciate the classless addressing need, actually, you need to understand classful. And in the day-to-day life also, when you are dealing with your host, local network, you are understanding it in a classful way. That is the reason. Otherwise, classful addressing architecture is nowhere in use in the real internet. I will tell you the reason why. I will explain you then what is the option and how classless addressing architecture came into the picture. Right? So let's look at. So basically, you have five classes. This is the rule of the thumb. You accept there are five classes. A से शुरू किया है और पांच classes है. तो E तक जाएगा. उसमें कुछ ज्यादा सोचने की जरूरत नहीं है. ये बच्चों को भी समझ में आ जाएगा. Right? चार बाइट्स है हमारे पास आईपी एड्रेस में, यू ऑलरेडी नो. फोर बाइट्स, द टोटल लेंथ इज 32 बिट्स, यू ऑलरेडी नो. सो ईच बाइट कैन हैव मैक्सिमम 8 बिट्स, राइट? नाउ हाउ दे हैव डन दिस कैटेगरीज, आई विल टेल यू. इन द क्लास ए माय फर्स्ट बिट वैल्यू इज फिक्स, विच इज 0. फॉर क्लास ए माय फर्स्ट बिट वैल्यू इज फिक्स्ड, विच इज एक्चुअली 0. Right, for class A, my first bit value is fixed, which is 0. For class B, my first two bits are fixed, which is 1, 0. For my class C, three bits are fixed, which is 1, 1, 0. For class D, my four bits are fixed, which is 1, 1, 0. And for class E, the first four bits are fixed, which are 4 times 1. I will tell you how this will be decided. See, the first byte value will decide the class of the IP address. The first byte value will decide the class of the IP address, right? So as my first bit value is 0, how many remaining bits you have out of this 8 bits? You have 7 bits, yes or no? Because my first bit value is 0, first bit value is 0, how many remaining bits I have? 7 bits. Now what could be the minimum value possible for this 7 bits? Yes, minimum value possible for this 7 bits is 0. So if I set all the 7 bits to 0, so all 8 bits become 0. And if all bits become 0, what decimal value I will get? 0. What is the maximum value possible for all the 7 bits that I have as an option? All the 7 bits, what I can set maximum value? All I set to 1. So this is corresponding to 64, 32, 16, 8, 4, 2, and 1. If you do the summation of 64, 32, 16, 8, 4, 2, and 1, you will get maximum value 127. And that's the reason why your range is from 0 to 127. 127, and which is written inside the box here. I hope it is clear, right? This is how the range came. Now, same thing for class B. You get the first two bits are fixed. First two bits are fixed, which is 1 and 0. So how many options you have now? First two bits are fixed. How many options I have now? Yes, somebody said correctly. I can listen to you. Somebody said correctly. How many options you have? 6. You have 6 options, friends. All these 6 bits can minimum value of 0. If I set all this value to 0, what I'm getting? 1. See, 1, 0 is already there. The remaining 6 are 0. So I'm getting 1 and 7 bits 0. If my 1 and 7 bits are 0, what is the decimal value I will get? Yes, somebody said correctly, it's 128. And what is the maximum value possible for all these 6 bits? 1. If I set all these 6 bits to 1, right? What is the value of this bit? 32. 32 plus 16 plus 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1. What do you will get? Yes, what you will get? 32 plus 16, you will get 63. Yes, you will get 63. 32 plus 16 plus 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1, you will get 63. So you do 128 plus 63. You are getting 191. That's how range. Same thing, you set 110 first 3 bits. How many remaining? 5. 5 bits ki minimum value kya possible hai? 0. Sare ko 0 kar do. 5 5 ko 0 kar do. Kya ho jayega? Ye 128 hai. Ye 64 hai. 128 plus 64 192. So you are getting 192. Aur ye sab ko 1 kar do. Sare ko. So it become 223. So that's how you are getting the range. You do like this. तो आपका फर्स्ट बाइट की वैल्यू कहीं पे भी आपको दिख जाए 0 से 127 में, तो आप क्या डिसाइड कर पाओगे? आईपी एड्रेस बिलोंग्स टू क्लास ए. 128 टू 191 में कोई भी आईपी एड्रेस दिख जाए क्लास बी. 192 टू 223 क्लास सी. नाउ प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड, क्लास ए बी एंड द क्लासेस विल गिव यू यूनिकास्ट आईपी एड्रेसेस. हेलो, दे विल गिव यू यूनिकास्ट आईपी एड्रेसेस. बिलीव मी, इफ आई वॉन्ट टू डेजिग्नेट एनी मशीन एज अ सोर्स और डेस्टिनेशन, it has to have a unicast IP address. It can, that means if I want to give an IP address to any machine or any device on the network, and that device has to get connected, it has to have an IP address either from class A or class B or class C. Class D is for multicasting. We will discuss later on. Class D is for multicasting, and class E is reserved for R&D. Is it decimal notation? Right, there are few fundamental things I keep explaining you. Look at this question now. So again, this question is related to ensure that you understand everything. Right, so find the class of each addresses. The first one. Yes, first one mein pehla bit 0 hai. Agar pehla bit 0 hai, toh hume kya karna hai? Wo class A ho gaya. Class A ho gaya, pehla. Right, second, B mein. आप पहली स्लाइड देख लो, डी में ये 110 110, अगर 110 है तो क्या हो गया? ये क्लास सी हो गया. गुड. नाउ 14 क्लास ए. वेरी गुड, 14 इज क्लास ए, बिकॉज कहीं पे भी मुझे दिख जाए 127 तक, मेरा क्या हो जाएगा? क्लास ए. और लास्ट वन 252 क्लास ई. राइट, सो दिस इज हाउ, सी लुक एट दियर, 252 यहाँ पोल होता है, 14 यहाँ पोल होता है, राइट, एंड दिस इज हाउ यू डिसाइडेड. क्लास ए फर्स्ट बीट वॉज 0, फर्स्ट 3 बीट वॉज 110, क्लास ई, राइट, सो दिस इज हाउ इट विल डू. राइट, सो दिस इज हाउ यू कैन डिसाइड द क्लास ऑफ एन आईपी एड्रेस. द टाइटल ऑफ द स्लाइड इज फ्रेंड्स, नेट आईडी एंड द होस्ट आईडी. I'm trying to say that the entire IP address, which has a 4 bytes or 32 bits, it has been divided into two parts. One part is called net ID, another part is called the host ID. Now you have an immediate question in your mind. Before all the three classes that you are talking about, I'm now talking about only the ABC, because they are capable of giving the unicast IP addresses. So in class A IP address, I have 4 bytes. Out of that 4 bytes, how many bytes for net ID? How many bytes for host ID? I will tell you, for class A, 1 byte is for net ID, first byte is for a net ID, and the remaining 3 bytes are for the host ID. I said that your IP addresses are divided into 2 parts, net ID and the host ID. For class A, the first byte is net ID, the remaining 3 bytes are host ID. For class B, the first 2 bytes are for net ID, the remaining 2 bytes are for host ID. And for class C, the first 3 bytes are for net ID, and the remaining byte is for the host ID. Is it clear to everyone? IP address ke kitne division hue? 3. Kitne division hue? 3. Two, very good, 2 division. The first division is, one division is called net ID, second one is called the host ID. Class B mein kitne bytes hai for host ID? In class B, how many bytes for host ID? Class B 2, right. In class C, how many bytes for host ID? Class C. class C, 1, 1. Class C, host ID 1, net ID 3. Class A, how many bytes for net ID? Class A, 1. Class A, how many bytes for host ID? 3. Very good. Right? So this is in front of you. So net ID, host ID, very important.